Hey guys, we're back and we've got more beer. I'm here with Jared Price once again. He is a professional beer drinker. We were just swapping Rolling Stones trivia back and forth and we got more beer to drink. So we got Adam Smasher. This is an Oktoberfest and it is it comes to us from Two Brothers Brewing Company in Illinois. And according to the bottle, it is a limited run artisan beer and a hefty full-bodied lager, reminiscent of Märzen beers from days gone by. This was recommended to us from one of the employees of Belmont Party Supply, who said it was a really good beer. And just as a little side note, If you want to get into drinking really good beers and be a beer snob, then you know, go to these places and ask the people that work there because they really know what they're talking about. I mean, this guy was about to go on and for like a 45-minute story, but he's like, I'll let you guys leave.
I'll let you guys go drink your beer. You don't need a beer lecture tonight. I think was his exact words. Yeah.
It is pretty cloudy. There's some little, I can kind of see some little particles in there. You know, probably from the different things that they put in for the Oktoberfest. It's not like there's little chunks of stuff in here. You can just barely see stuff floating around, but you don't feel it at all in your mouth.
No.
It is an Oktoberfest, so I describe the color as pumpkin-y. it's a pumpkin color.
Yeah, it really is.
You know, it's a really nice color.
Yeah.
You can just kind of barely see through it. The aroma is, like I said, very malty, not very carbonated at all. There's barely any head and then whatever head was there is kind of disappeared.
It's already gone.
I mean, it certainly doesn't smell hoppy. It's only like 22 or something. IBU, so.
Yeah, 22.6.
Not carbonated. I mean, it's a very, very, very lightly carbonated. There's a little bit of bubble coming up, but, I mean, this almost is like a, as far as the mouthfeel, it's almost like a juice.
Yeah. You know, almost like cider.
Mm-hmm. The flavor isn't cider.
No, the flavor's not cider. But it's a little thick. I mean, not too bad, really. But like you said, you know, consistent-wise, you know, mouthfeel, you know, it's a little thicker, I would say, than juice, you know.
Yeah, like a...
Like,
it, yeah,
like a cider.
It is like a cider, yeah. It's very malty. It's not quite as malty as I expected from the smell, but... I'm getting some cinnamon, some kind of almost like spiciness from like cinnamon, a little bit of caramel.
Yeah, I mean it's sweet, but not too sweet. I mean it's not overpowering. That, you know, that maltiness will do that. You know, almost like a honey aftertaste.
Yeah. There's a tartness to it too. I'm getting a lot of that tartness right now.
Yeah.
I think as it warms up, it
comes out more.
Right. Yeah. I'm getting some of the Vienna malts in here and the Munich malts. I was expecting this to be a lot more malty. I'm glad that guy. Suggested
yeah,
this to
actually
us.
Yeah, I'm really glad he suggested this.
He said, he came up to us and he said, you're going to want to try that beer right there.
Yeah, we just so happened to be standing where it was on the shelf looking over, you know, what we were going to drink tonight.
Yeah.
And he pointed out to us, and I'm not disappointed, believe
me.
Yeah,
me neither. Well... We've only got about halfway through this bottle here, but you know what do you think the score is?
For me, I'm gonna put this at a 4, and you know it's really my style of beer. I like a little on the sweeter side, not so hoppy. And this is, I mean, definitely
right up
my kind of beer.
Right. As for the flavor, my score of it, I would give it a 4.2. You know, like I said, I like the hoppier beers. But, and this is by no means hoppy.
No.
I don't really taste any hops. I mean, maybe a little bit of flavor from the hops, but yeah. No bitterness from the hops.
Not
well, we need to finish up these beers here, but I appreciate you watching. You know, let me know what you think about this beer, if you've had it. You know, how does it compare to other Oktoberfests? And, you know, give me some information about this. We kind of went into this blind, just based off the suggestion of the employee. And in retrospect, I wish we would have asked him a little bit more, get some more info on it. But if you have any info on it, you know, I'm probably gonna do a lot of research on this now that I've drank it. But you know, leave me a comment, let me know. And thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.
See you later, guys.